The University of Bristol is a long-term HPE customer. We've worked with them for many years and supplied them with a variety of supercomputers. The decision to purchase Isambard-AI is part of the UK's government's strategy to invest in science and technology to become a scientific superpower by 2030.
This all comes from the UK government recognising a real need for AI computational capability for the country, which we didn't have. When we've been putting this together, we've partnered with HPE, and we've co-designed Isambard-AI with HPE, and with NVIDIA, who are providing the Grace Hopper GH200s.
So let me talk a bit about the bits. So the bits are based around Hewlett Packard Enterprise's Cray EX platform, a water-cooled enclosure where we put blades, and these blades are effectively the compute nodes. We connect them together with our proprietary low-latency slingshot, and then we put our software across it and connect it to appropriate storage. The blades themselves are based around the Grace Hopper superchip, the H200.
One of the exciting things about AI workloads is they're still evolving very rapidly. So you can't build a system that's too rigid, that's too specialized for one particular thing, or maybe how we're doing things right now, because in a year or two, it might be completely different. So you actually still need an AI supercomputer to be quite agile and quite flexible. That's quite a good, important thing for GPUs, because there are other AI processors that can just do specific things. We took that very much into account when we were designing Isambard AI.
And if you take the 64-bit premise that old-fashioned supercomputing people like me use and turn it into AI flops, you find that this is going to be 21 exaflops.
Now, these numbers are huge. It's very hard to imagine what they really mean. So one way to think of it is if everybody on Earth did one calculation every second, it would take 83 years using everyone on Earth to do how many things Isambard can do in just 1 second. The site that we're using is at the National Composite Centre in Bristol, and they're a site that develops composite materials, next generation of technologies that we'll be building cars and planes out of. And so they will be using simulations to actually design their materials using AI techniques before they actually make them. So I think that's AI is going to have a huge impact on that kind of industry. Isambard AI is named after Isambard Kingdom Brunel, who was a very famous Victorian engineer in the UK. He was kind of the Steve Jobs of the Victorian era. He came up with lots of firsts. He designed the world's first iron-hulled propeller-driven ship. He built tunnels, he built bridges. He was a real innovator, a real problem solver. And that's one of the places that I think AI is really going to have an impact. It's going to really help scientists and engineers come up with new ideas, come up with new techniques, and solve problems in a way that we just haven't been able to do before. So this really is, it's like the modern day equivalent of having Isambard right next to you, helping you and speaking in your ear and helping you solve problems.